Hello again, welcome back to another video. This one, we're going to be using PlantUML in Visual Studio Code and doing domain models. So this model that I have defined here is the domain model for the game of Risk. You might know that game. Maybe you played it when you were younger. Maybe you still play it. Anyway, Risk is a game that's played on a board. So Risk board. You have several players, you use dice, and the goal is to capture as many countries as possible. So in that game, we can think of these domain classes. So let me show you in PlantUML how this works. We've got the classes already there. So we can see the player class, which has an attribute of string. I have the die class, which has an attribute of an integer. And then we have a game class that doesn't have any attributes. It's just game. And I want to show you a little trick here in PlantUML. You can see I've used these as the syntax dice or die as die, which is a way to, in fact, name a class. And I'm going to show you that right now. I'm going to rename, for example, the class Risk game. Going to rename the name of the game to Risk game, and you'll see that it updates here. And the nice thing is that when I say as game, that's sort of like a variable for the class itself. So the display of this class is going to use Risk game, the part in quotes, and the name for it in the rest of the model will be game. So that's a useful trick to allow you to modify how you display your classes without breaking the model. So we have Risk board, same trick here. I'm using it, just calling it board, but it's displayed as Risk board. Country as country with a single attribute of name. Actually, I've got it in French. I can fix that. It should be name. And now we see those are the classes which show up here. Now let's look at how do we define an association. I actually have all the associations that I've worked out before ahead of time, but I will show them to you one by one. I'm going to remove these there. Well, not really remove them, but I will take them and change them from being comments back to code, because what I did was commented out all of these lines. And in Visual Studio Code, the comment is just the control with the slash. And so if I'm on a line and I hit control slash, it then either toggles a comment. And so this comment is now a regular line. And I can see the relationship now between the game and the board. And we have, just taking it apart step by step here, we have a cardinality of 1. And you have to put your cardinalities in quotes in PlantUML. And here we have the association, which is star dash dash, which is basically saying use composition. That star is what's giving you the diamond here in the diagram. And then the dash dash is telling it to use a vertical layout for the association. So the classes will be laid out vertically. And then the colon is saying that there's a part here which will be the text that displays on the association, and that text is played on, which is sort of the notation that we use here. And I have an angle bracket at the end, which is like an arrow. It's pointing in the direction that you read it. For example, game is played on board. So that direction is from left to right. But as you can see, it has laid out the things from top to bottom. And PlantUML took into consideration the direction of that angle bracket when it laid it out. So it actually is pointing down. I can now show you, if you want to lay it out horizontally, you take away one of these dashes. And you will see that it has changed in the layout, it's horizontal, but it's also now changed the triangle to be in the same direction as the readability. So game is played on a board. So PlantUML is pretty cool with layouts. You don't have to mess around with too much stuff. That's one of the reasons I really like it. So let's look at the other associations. We have a game that is played with 5 dice. So we can see that association being created there. It's also a vertical layout. Again, with composition, I would look at the next line. I can do again a control slash that will toggle the comment. The game, in this case, it's a little bit different. It's game is played by 2 to 6 players. Now I want to show you a little trick here. I could say player is a player plays the game, and in this case, I'm going to change it around. Instead of saying is played by, I can say plays. So I want to say player plays a game, but in this case, the arrow is going to be the opposite direction. So I will change the bracket. And you can see here it's now fixed it to say player plays risk game. So you have a lot of flexibility if you want to use the order. If you want to change the order of things, you can put the arrow going the right direction. You can change the way you write your verb. Again, a lot of flexibility. So let's look at the next one. Here we have player is throwing or throws 1, 2, or 3 dice. And that's going to show up as the relationship here. And what I wanted to show is that you can use a comma for separate numbers. Now we can go to the next one and look at that one. It's board is composed of or contains 42 countries. So we see that relationship here, board composition with 42 countries with contains. And I will do the next one, which is a country which is a neighbor of several countries. And this is capturing the relationship in the game where some countries you can move into other countries. And the notion of connectivity is there, is a neighbor of. The next one we have a player controls countries. And that's going to give us the player and the country here. And of course, the object of the game is to control all the countries if you can. And I wanted to show you the last one, which is a little bit interesting because you can do this in PlantUML and also in domain models. You have this notion of an association class. And the association class is a class which really is it's connected to an association, not to really or their attributes. And this, I think this is a good case where you might want to see this. And that is, again, when a player controls a country, that means there's armies in the country. And so what I've done here is I will see this syntax where you have an association class. So it takes the two classes between where there is an association. And so we already have player and country having an association controls. But now what we're going to do is we're going to say on that association, we're going to have a class that's connected to the association. It's called occupation. Occupation meaning there's armies occupying that country, and they're from the player and to the country. And of course, an occupation is a class, so we can actually specify how many armies by declaring it as a class in PlantUML. We say the number of armies is an integer. So now we can see the class with occupation here. Okay, so that's a lot of stuff here just for a domain model. I hope this is useful for you, and thanks again for watching.